In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak. We give thanks to God for giving us this opportunity to attend this service online.
我们感谢天，我们的真神，让我们有机会能来在线上来参加聚会。
And we pray that all of us shall be edified by the word of God.
那么我们祈求说，在座听的每一位都能够从中得到造就。
We have been told that you know the word of God is likened to our spiritual food.
那我们晓得说，神的话语对我们来说就是我们的灵粮。
Many a time we realize that you know the word of God does not really satisfy us.
但是我们很常会发现说呢，神的话语不能够来满足我们。
The reason, the problem is not with the word of God.
那么问题不在于神的话。
In most cases, in fact, the problem lies with ourselves.
绝大部分的时候呢，问题在于我们。
So when we have a correct mindset in drawing close to God to listen to His word, then surely we shall be edified.
那么，当我们有正确的思维，想要来亲近神、来聆听神的话语的时候呢，那我们肯定会从中得到造就。
And so we hope that tonight our mindset can be renewed by the Holy Spirit.
那我们祈求说，我们的心思意念今晚能够被圣灵来唤醒。
So that the simple word of God can be of great help to our spiritual life.
让神简单的话语能够成为我们属灵生活的帮助。
Tonight, I'm going to continue with our topic, remain in God's salvation for a mutual exhortation.
那么今天要和大家继续来探讨并且来分享的题目，就是保守在神的话语中。
Like what we have spoken before, after Adam has sinned against God, the entire world plunged into sin.
那么我们之前有提到说呢，亚当犯了罪以后呢，就让全世界陷在罪里。
In reality, our destiny is condemnation.
那我们的命运，最终，就是要被定罪。
But by the grace of God, we are saved, we are ushered into His body, His church.
那么借着神的恩典，我们是被救赎，是被召入他的身体，他的教会里头。
Most preciously, we are given this salvation, the grace of salvation.
那么更宝贵的就是我们被赐予这宝贵的救恩。
The Bible also teaches us that, however, this grace of salvation can be lost.
但是圣经有教导我们说，这个救恩是能够丧失的。
Therefore, we must remain in high alert to ensure that you know the grace of salvation shall always be with us.
那我们要时刻的保持高度警醒的状态当中，让我们不会轻易的丧失这样的救恩。
We have witnessed for ourselves how brothers and sisters in Christ, you know, some of them have lost their salvation.
那么也曾经亲眼见证说，曾经是在基督身体里头的弟兄姐妹呢，也是这样的来丧失了他们的救恩。
They lost their salvation by departing from their faith and by departing from the church.
那么他们之所以会丧失了他们救恩，是因为他们放弃了信仰，放弃了教会。
It goes to show that, you know, to be steadfast in the Lord is never easy.
那么若是要在神当中站得稳的话呢，这是不简单的。
That is the reason why we need a constant reminder from the Word of God to stand firm in God and His grace.
那么这是我们为什么需要从神的话语当中时常的得到提醒，让我们能够继续在他的救恩还有恩典当中站立的稳。
So tonight I'm going to look at some situations in life that we may be in can pose a threat to our salvation.
那么今天和大家探讨几个例子说，也许在生命当中有些处境会对于我们的救恩会形成挑战。
We always, say that we need to use the Word of God as our guiding principle in life.
那我们时常说我们要用神的话语，当做我们生命中的指引。
We use the Word of God to measure against our behavior, our deeds.
那我们用神的话语来评估自己的行为、言行举止。
When we also use the Word of God to mold our thinking and mindset.
那么我们也利用神的话语来塑造我们的思维。
The reason is that because sometimes our thinking can be influenced by the world.
但是我们的想法有时候会被世界来影响。
A misconception, if not corrected, can lead us astray.
那若是有没有有误解，我们没有去处理的话呢，那会让我们偏离正道。
The Bible talks about the Jewish people who rejected Jesus Christ.
那么圣经中有提到拒绝耶稣的犹太人。
As a result, the gospel of God was given to the Gentiles.
那么结果就是神的救恩就临到外邦人身上。
We turn to the book of Acts, chapter 28.
我们请看《使徒行传》28章。
We turn to the book of Acts, chapter 28.
我们请看《使徒行传》28章。
We read verse 28.
请看28节。
Verse 28, therefore, let it be known to you that the salvation of God has been sent to the Gentiles, and they will hear it.
28节，所以你们当知道，神这救恩如今传给外邦人，他们也必听受。
This chapter talks about the final phase of Paul's ministry at Rome.
那么这一章提到保罗在罗马传道的行程的最后一个阶段。
He was under house arrest.
那么他是被拘留的。
And at the time, he managed to persuade many people to come to listen to the word.
但是在那个时候呢，他就能有说服了许多人来听神的道。
I want you to read also verse 24.
我们也请看24节。
And some were persuaded by the things which were spoken, and some disbelieved.
24节，他所说的话，有信的，有不信的。
So you find that those who did not believe in what Paul preached, they left him.
那么那些不相信保罗所说的话的人呢？他们就离开了保罗。
So Paul actually drew a conclusion, from their departure.
那么保罗就从他们这样离开他来做了一个结论。
In fact, this is like the fulfillment of the scriptures.
那么是成全了经书所说的话。
Because these people with ears they can never understand.
因为这些人有耳却不能听懂。
And with eyes they can never perceive accurately.
他们要是看见，却不晓得。
And because of the refusal to listen and to accept the gospel of salvation, and Paul said to them that, and therefore, this grace was given to the Gentiles.
因为他们拒绝来聆听保罗所说的话，不接受这个福音，那么保罗就对他们说，神的救恩如今要传给外邦人。
So according to the predictions of Paul here. Is that the Gentiles will hear?
那么根据保罗这样来做推测呢？外邦人必要聆听。
We understand that the Jewish people refuse to listen. One of the reason being that because they have a wrong concept of themselves and of their belief.
那么我们晓得说，犹太人不愿意来聆听这福音的其中一个原因呢，因为他们对是因为他们对自己的身份有所误解。
Because they believe that they were the descendants of Abraham, it's like, you know, they were guaranteed to receive salvation.
那么他们想说自己是亚伯拉罕的后裔，那么他们想说他们一定能够领受救恩。
Because of this mindset, you find that, you know, any other teachings which are contrary, you know, to their belief, that they would refuse to listen.
那么，因为他们有这样的想法呢，那么要是听见与这样的想法不同的道的话呢，他们是不会来接受的。
We turn to the Gospel of Luke chapter 3.
你请看《路加福音》三章。
Please turn to the Gospel of Luke chapter 3. We read verse 8.
你请看《路加福音》三章八节。
Verse 8, and here is a reprimand from John the Baptist to the Jewish people at the time.
那么这样的施洗约翰正来责备当时的犹太人。
Verse 8,
八节。
and therefore bear fruits worthy of repentance, and do not begin to say to yourselves, We have Abraham as our father. For I said to you that God is able to raise up children to Abraham from these stones.
八节，你们要结出果子来，与悔改的馨相称，不要自己心里说，有亚伯拉罕为我们的祖宗。我告诉你们，神能从这些石头中给亚伯拉罕兴起子孙来。
They took pride in the fact that they were the descendants of Abraham.
那么他们就因为他们是亚伯拉罕的子孙呢，就引以为傲。
So because of that, they refused to listen to the message of John.
那么就因为如此呢，他们不愿意来领受施洗约翰所传的信息。
And you find that because of their refusal, and obviously they would not repent of their wrongs.
那因为他们这样子的不愿意来接受这番的话呢，那么他们就没有悔改。
And we understand that being unrepentant can cause a person to lose his salvation.
那么要是一个人不愿意悔改的话呢，那么这人最终会丧失他的救恩。
So from here we can say that they were not able to hear the word, and nor can they see themselves clearly with the word of God.
那么这些人不单不能够来聆听神的话，更不能够在神的话里看清自己。
So I think it is important for us to always fine-tune our mindset with the word of God.
那我想说，重要的事情就是我们要时常来利用神的话语来调整自己的想法。
Remain in a particular mode of thinking can cause us to become stubborn, or can cause us to become rebellious.
那要是我们对我们自己的想法要是坚持不放手的话呢，那么这会让我们变得固执，变得在神面前变得是顽梗的。
This actually is a form of pride.
那这是一种骄傲。
Because pride would blind the eyes of the person concerned.
那么一骄傲会让这人的眼目呢变得瞎眼。
To an extent that you know, the person would not be able to see himself clearly and to mend his wrongs.
甚至让这个人不能够来看清自己的错误，并且来改正过来。
We can look at Revelation chapter 3.
我们可以看启示录第三章。
The message to the last church, the church of Laodicea.
那么这是对这最后一间教会，就是老底家教会的信息。
Here God warns the church sternly.
那么神在这里很严厉的来警告这教会。
If they remain in the state that they were,
那么他们要是继续的处在这样的处境当中的话呢？
That is neither cold nor hot, then God would spill them out.
那么他们要是继续的也不冷也不热的话呢，那么神就必从他的口中把他们吐出去。
This is likened, you know, to being cast out of, you know, the presence of the Lord.
那么这就好比从神的面前被赶出去一样。
Now you find that the church here was not able to see herself very clearly.
那么当时我们可以看见呢，当时教会不能够看清自己。
If you look at the mindset of the church in general, is that you know everyone would think that you know they are fine, they are well, you know, in the sight of God.
那么当时这教会的思维当中呢，他们应该是觉得自己说是没有问题的。
I want you to read verse 17.
我们可以看十七节。
Chapter 3, verse 17.
三章十七节。
And because you said, I am rich, have become wealthy, and have need of nothing, and do not know that you are wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked.
你说我是富足，已经发了财，一样都不缺，却不知道你是那困苦、可怜、贫穷、瞎眼、赤身的。
This is a remark from God concerning, you know, the church at Laodicea.
那么这是神对这老底家教会的这样的一个评估。
They were not able to see themselves.
他们不能够看清自己。
They have this false sense of security.
他们有这样错误的一种安全感。
Because they you know, they thought that they were good and they were well, you know, in God's presence.
因为他们想说他们在神的面前呢是没有问题的。
So without a deep, you know, searching into themselves, they can never discover what was within them, what was in them.
他们要是没有来仔细的来审，深入的来审查自己的话呢？那他们是不会发觉到他们是有所缺陷的。
In life, we are very much used to our routine. For example, the way we worship God and the way we serve God.
那也许我们对我们敬拜神的方法，服侍神的方法呢，也许对我们说是一种习惯。
We hardly, you know, examine ourselves carefully.
那我们没有很常的来审查自己。
And that is the reason why, at times, we cannot know ourselves very well.
之所以呢，我们不能够来好好的来认识自己。
You know, to remain in that situation is risky.
那要是我们继续的处于这样的状态的话呢，这是是很有风险的。
We can you know even lose our salvation eventually if we do not turn back quickly to God.
那要是我们不速速的转回向神的话呢，甚至会让我们丧失我们的救恩。
So in the message given here, they were told yeah, to buy gold, refined gold from God, and buy white garments and also eye salve from the Lord.
那么这里就这样说，神就劝他们要向他买火炼金子，又买白衣穿上，又买眼药擦他们的眼睛。
To buy gold so that can be rich in faith.
向神买火炼的金晶，叫他们能够在信仰上得到富足。
To have a white garment so that their nakedness may not be seen.
又买白衣穿上，叫他们赤身的羞耻不露出来。
To buy these ointments from God.Is to enable them to see clearly.
那么又向神买眼药，擦他们的眼睛，让他们能够清楚来看见。
And you find that these actions are connected to knowing the word of God.
那么这些行动呢，就和来认识神的话语是有关系的。
We ask, where does faith come from?
那么我们会问说，信仰是从哪里来的呢？
According to Paul, faith, you know, come from hearing the word of God.
那根据保罗的说法呢，信心是从听神的话开始。
So when we listen, we do not just listen, you know, casually, then we should listen attentively with a God-fearing heart.
那么聆听呢，不单只是随意的来聆听，而是要用专注的来聆听。
So with the word of God, you know, we know that where we have fallen short of the standard of God.
这会让我们晓得说我们在神的标准上是在哪里有所不足。
So with the word of God, what we change our behavior, our mindset, our nakedness is covered.
那么借用神的话语呢，我们能够来改正我们的过失。
We may not be able to see the things of God or the grace of God readily in life.
那么也许在生命当中，我们不能够清楚来看见神的恩典。
But we see that when our eyesight are brightened up by the Word of God.
但是我们的眼睛要是被神的话来点亮的话呢？
Then we are able to perceive the matters of God clearly.
那我们就能够来清楚来对神的事情呢有更清楚的认知。In
this way, we can follow God wholeheartedly.
那么要是这样呢，我们就能够来全心全意的来跟从神。With
a clear direction in place.
而且是有很清楚的方向的。So
in this way, we find that we are kept in God's salvation.
那么借着这样呢，我们就会在神的救恩当中呢被保守。So
even when we are in Christ, if we are not careful, we can end up losing our salvation.
即使说我们是在基督里头，但是要是不小心的话呢，我们还是可以丧失救恩的。So
we need to have a correct understanding of ourselves.
那么我们要对自己有正确还有清楚的认知。Now
the second example.
那么第二个例子呢?
I want to look at Proverbs.
Yeah. 我们请看箴言。
Proverbs chapter 20.
箴言20章。
Proverbs chapter 20, we read verse 22.
箴言20章22节。
22, do not say, I will recompense evil. Wait for the Lord, and he will save you.
22节，你不要说我要以恶报恶，要等候耶和华，他必拯救你。
Here is like we are told that we need to count on God, especially when we encounter evil in life.
那么我们这里劝勉我们说要来等候耶和华，尤其是当我们面对恶事的时候。
When we are, you know, ill-treated, or when we are in a very difficult circumstance.
或许我们是被别人来恶待，或许我们处于困难的处境当中。
Here the advice is that, you know, we must wait for the Lord, and he will save us.
那这里的劝诫就是说呢，我们要等候耶和华，他必拯救你。
So the question arises here is that in what way do you think God will save those who wait on him?
那么这里的问题就是说，神要如何来拯救那些等候他的人呢？
When you look at the book of Psalms, for example,
举例来说，我们看诗篇的时候呢，
many of the psalmists, you know, talk about their personal experiences in life.
那么其中的诗人呢，很常会提到他们亲身的体验。
Many of those experiences are connected to how they were oppressed by their enemies.
那么他们这样的体验呢，很常是被他们的敌人来欺压。
Or how you know they rely on God, accounted on God to pass through a very hostile period of time.
那么还有提到说他们是如何来依赖神来度过这些难关。
I want you to look at one example, yeah, and to help us think about this issue.
那我们可以来探讨一个例子，让我们来了解这一点。
We know that the Old Testament scriptures, many parts of the scriptures, of the Old Testament scriptures, talk about Jesus Christ.
我们知道说旧约经书当中呢，有很多很多部分都在提到耶稣基督。
There are many prophecies concerning Jesus Christ.
那么有许多的预言是谈论到耶稣基督的。
Concerning the sufferings that he would go through.
谈论到他所要经历的痛苦。
And the shame and the sins that he must bear.
还有他必须要来承担的羞耻，还有罪。
You find that all these prophecies, many of which have been fulfilled in the New Testament.
那么许多的这些预言呢，已经在新约经书当中已经是成全的了。
I want you to read the book of Psalms, chapter 22.
我们请看诗篇22篇。
We know that this part of the scriptures is talking about Jesus Christ and his suffering and how he was brutally attacked.
那我们晓得这段经书，我们晓得它是在描述耶稣基督，所经历的痛苦，还有他是怎么来被恶人来攻击的。
For example, from 16 to verse 18,
那么，例如说，在16到18节呢？
we can actually see this fulfillment in the gospel, for example, Matthew chapter 27.
那么，我们可以例如说，在马太福音20章，看见这一段经书被实现出来。
I want you to read verse 19 to verse 21.
我们请看19到21节。
The book of Psalms, chapter 22, verse 19 to verse 21.
诗篇22篇19到21节。
But you, O Lord, do not be far from me. All my strength hasten to help me. Verse 20. Deliver me from the sword. My precious life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth and from the horns of the wild oxen. You have answered me.
19节，耶和华，求你不要远离我，我的救主啊，求你快来帮助我。20节，求你救我的灵魂脱离刀剑，救我的生命脱离犬类。21节，救我脱离狮子的口，你已经应允我，使我脱离野牛的角。
We can look at this passage in the light of David's suffering.
那我们可以从大卫所经历的痛苦这样的观点来看这一段经书。
We know that David was like a fugitive, when he was pursued after by King Saul.
那么当大卫在被扫罗追杀的时候呢，他就好像一个逃难者一样。
After he became king, because he sinned against God, and God allowed his son Absalom to go after.
那么他在当王以后呢，因为他向神犯罪，神就让他的儿子亚沙龙来篡夺他的王位。
And when you look at this passage, we can also look at it in the light of Christ's suffering in this world, and
那我们呢？
particularly, during the last part of his life before his crucifixion.
那么我们也可以用这段经书来探讨耶稣基督在世上所受的痛苦，尤其是在他在被钉十字架前的那一段时间。
If we say that this part of the scriptures is a reference to Christ's sufferings,
那我们若是说这一段经书是指着基督所受的苦的话呢？
And there is a question that we need to ask and answer.
那有一个问题，我们需要来问，并且来解答。
We look at verse 21.
我们请看21节。
And the last part, is like, he said with confidence that God has answered him.
那么在21节的后半段呢，诗人就很有信心的说，神已经应允他。
Now, when you look at the real life story of Jesus,
那要是我们来 耶稣基督他的所经历的事情的时候呢？
Particularly, events leading up to his crucifixions.
尤其是在他被钉十字架前所发生的一连串的事情。
We see that he eventually died on the cross.
最终呢，他是死在十字架上的。
So the question is, in what way do you think God has answered him?
那问题就是说，我们觉得说神是如何来应允他的呢？
How did God save him?
神是如何来拯救他的呢？
Now, when you look at the New Testament scriptures,
当我们在阅读新约经书的时候呢？
especially the book of Hebrews,
尤其是希伯来书。
We are told that he has become the author of our salvation because of his submissions to God.
那因为他来顺服者呢，他就成为了我们信心的始祖。
We understand that physically he died on the cross.
那么在肉身上来，这肉身上来说呢，他的确是死在十字架上。
The Bible does tell us that death cannot take control over him.
那么圣经告诉我们说，死不能来辖制他。
This is how he has broken free from the ensnarement of sin and death.
那他就因为这样呢，他就脱离了罪的牵绊还有捆绑。
So by looking at this, we understand that God has answered his prayer because he has not become disobedient to God in the process.
那么小的时候，神应允了他，因为他，sorry。
Because he did not disobey God in the process.
因为他在这过程当中呢，没有来来背逆神。
Because of his submission, that's why he has become the author, of salvation to all those who believe in him.
那么他就因为如此呢，成为了一切信他的人的信心的创始成终的耶稣。
So today we have to do the same in order to keep ourselves from being condemned.
那么对于我们来说，我们要将自己保守在耶稣当中，让我们不至于被定罪。
That is, we must obey God to the very end.
那么要这样的做来做呢，我们一定要顺服神到底。
Circumstances in life may pose a huge challenge to our faith.
也许生命中的我们所遇见的事情呢，会对我们信仰造成很大的挑战。
However, as long as we hold on to our faith, we shall become victorious.
但只要我们持守我们的信心的话呢，我们一定会得胜。
So, in the eyes of God, we are well preserved in His grace and in His salvation.
那么在神的眼中呢，我们在他的恩典还有他救恩当中是被保守的。
We understand that from the Bible, we are not supposed to repay evil with evil.
那么圣经告诉我们说，我们不能以恶报恶。
We know that Jesus Christ in this world, he had the authority to summon, angels to destroy his enemy.
我们知道在这世上的时候呢，耶稣基督是有这个能力来召唤天上的天使呢，来战胜他的仇敌。
But instead, he kept silence, to endure, unfairness, and in order to achieve the plan of salvation of God.
但是他却是保持沉默，来承受这样的不公义。让我们来成全这个救赎的恩公。
We can turn to First Peter.
我们可以看彼得前书。
We turn to First Peter chapter 2.
彼得前书二章。
We read verse 21.
我们请看21节。
For to this you were called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his steps. Verse 22, who committed no sin, nor was deceit found on his mouth.
二十一节，你们蒙召原是为此，因基督也为你们受过苦，给你们留下榜样，叫你们跟随他的脚中行。二十二节，他并没有犯罪，口里也没有诡诈。
Verse 23.
23节。
Who, when he was reviled, did not revile in return? When he suffered, he did not threaten, but committed himself to him who judges righteously.
23节，他被骂不还口，受害不说威吓的话，只将自己交托那按公义审判人的主。
So here we can see, you know, how a Christ, you know, submitted fully to God by remaining silent in his suffering.
那么这里让我们看见基督是如何来完全来顺服神，而将自己交在神手中。
But we need to understand that sometimes our suffering is the result of our own sin.
那我们要晓得说，我们所经历的困苦呢，也许是因为我们罪的缘故。
If that's the case, you know, then there's nothing for us to boast about.
那若是如此的话呢，那我们是没有什么可夸口的。
If we truly suffer for a righteous cause,
但是我们若是为公义的原因来受苦的话呢
，for the good of the church,
为了教会的好。
then you know we have to follow the example of Christ in order to emerge a victorious.
那我们要跟着基督的榜样，让我们最终能够来得胜。
So by doing that, we actually keep our soul in the Lord.
我们若是这样行的话，我们会在主里保守我们的灵魂。
Now we are going to look at one more example.
我们再看多一个例子。
Return to Matthew.
我们去看马太福音。
Return to Matthew chapter 24.
我们请看马太福音24章。
We read verse 13.
请看13节。
Matthew chapter 24, verse 13.
马太福音24章13节。
But he who endures to the end shall be saved.
13节，唯有忍耐到底的必然得救。
We know that chapter 24, you know, contains messages that Jesus has spoken to his disciples.
24章记载的就是耶稣对他门徒所说的一番话。
Here Jesus is talking about, you know, events that would happen, so things that would transpire before his second coming.
那么他就在这里谈论到在他的二度再临之前呢，所要发生的一些事情。
If you read verse 11 and verse 12, we can see how chaotic, you know, the community of faith would become.
那么11到12节可以让我们看见信仰团体当中混乱的这个状态。
Just like what Paul mentioned or stated in Acts of the Apostles chapter 20.
那么就像使徒保罗在使徒行传20章所提到的。
Many would rise up from within the community to speak perverse things.
那么有许多人会从信仰团体当中兴起来，并且说荒谬的话。
You find that the teachings of Christ are pretty identical to that of Paul's.
那么发现说，基督的这样的教导呢，和保罗的教导是非常相似的。
So when falsehood begins to emerge in the church,
当这些假道开始在教会中兴起来的时候呢？
And you find that their lawlessness will multiply as well.
那么不法的事情就会增加。
The lawlessness here refers to people who refuse, you know, to function according to the principles and the laws of God.
那么这里不法的事情就是指着这些人不愿意来跟着神的这些原则来行事。
So in this difficult circumstance, what should we do?
在这样困难的处境当中呢，我们当做的是什么呢
？We know that we can never depart from the church.
我们知道说我们不能离开教会。
In fact, you know, the thought of leaving the church must never cross our mind.
甚至是说想要离开教会这样的念头不能够浮现在我们脑海当中。
Because departing from the church means salvation is lost.
因为离开教会的意思就是说我们会丧失我们的救恩。
So the only way forward is to endure to the very end.
那么向前行唯一的方法就是要忍耐到底。
So, you know, you find that yeah, to have this spiritual quality that is being patient in all circumstances is crucial to our salvation.
那么要有这样属灵的特质，就是在凡事中忍耐到底呢，这对我们的救恩是非常重要的。
You realize that one of the things that we must do in this circumstance is to pray that the will of God be done.
那我们在这样的处境当中呢，我们要做的是祈求说神的旨意会成全。
So and to give us the power and you know the endurance, yeah, to continue to hold on to the faith.
那么求神给我们这样能力，这样的忍耐，来继续来持守我们的信仰到底。
And we must learn from the attitudes of Christ.
那么我们要从基督这样的榜样来学习。
One of the reasons for him to emerge victorious in times of temptation or in times of trial.
那他在被试探被试验当中能够得胜的原因呢？
He is able to look down on the shame that he suffered.
就是在乎他能够来看清他所忍受的这些凌辱。
Because he was able to see what was ahead of him.
因为他能够看得见在他前头的事情。
Today, you know, if we can see, you know, how wonderful, you know, God has prepared, you know, the place that God has prepared for us.
那要是我们能够来看得见神为我们的所预备的地方是有多么的美好。
If we can actually, you know, experience or feel, you know, the goodness of being with Him.
要是我们能够来真正来体验。与神同在这样的美好的话呢
then you find that the suffering that we are going through will mean nothing to us, will not affect us at all.
那我们今时今刻所经历的这些痛苦呢，对我们来说是完全我们不会在乎。
Because we can see what God has put has prepared for us in the future.
因为我们看得见神为我们预备好的事情。
So we need this spiritual eyesight to be able to perceive this heavenly kingdom.
我们需要拥有这样属灵的眼光呢，让我们能够看见天国的事情。
You know, this heavenly kingdom must not just remain, you know, as a kind of concept, you know, which is, you know, hard to understand.
那我们对于天国这件事情不能够只是当作是一种想法来看待。
And you know, without this spiritual eyesight, we can never understand how good the kingdom of God is to us.
要是没有这样属灵的眼光呢，我们永远不能够来明白神所为我们预备的是有多么的美好。
You find that God enables us to see this if.We always exercise faith in our life.
那神会让我们看见的条件就是我们要在我们日常生活当中实践我们的信心出来。
That is, we believe in God, we put His word into practice.
那就是说我们相信神，我们将他的话语体现出来。
And we draw close to Him.
并且来亲近他。
And these are the simple things that we must do in order to see.The kingdom of God in the future.
那么这些简单的事情，我们一定要来做，让我们能够看见神未来的天国。
So we hope that all of us can remember this.
希望大家能够明白这一点。
And hope that we can always endure with the power of the Holy Spirit.
那么借着圣灵所赐的能力呢，让我们继续的能够来忍耐到底。
In this way, we will not lose our salvation, the salvation that God has given to us.
我们要是这样做，我们就不会丧失神所赐给我们的救恩。
Thank God that my sermon ends here.
感谢神，我的证道就到此。